Well, the nicest weather for teachers will be taken to the picket lines today because parents get ready to keep your kids at home as teachers are striking again after a 10-month pay agreement impasse between the Post Primary Teachers Association and the government. Secondary teachers are launching into rolling year-level strikes. The first one is kicking off today with PPTA members refusing to teach all Year 11 classes. Here is Tessa Parker with how we got to this point.
This year, teachers have been making their voices heard.
Teachers walking off the floor, that is why we're here today!
There was historic strike action, with the PPTA and NZEI joining forces. Then further picketing from secondary school teachers. And the start of Term 2 brought a refusal to work outside of scheduled hours.
Negotiations between the Post-Primary Teachers Association and the government have been going for around 11 months, with teachers demanding better pay and working conditions. Only one offer's been made, that was in October, and teachers say it's not good enough.
All we are asking for is a pay increase that matches inflation and working conditions.
The fact that I am making basically minimum wage, which is the same amount of a lot of my students.
27 in my class at the moment, and that's considered a small class.
The Employment Relations Authority was brought in to help negotiations, acting as an independent third party to facilitate discussion. But 2 weeks into Term 2, no collective agreement has been reached.
It's a sad thing if the government are not willing to support the teachers in Aotearoa.
Meaning today, Year 11 students across the country get the day off school. Next week, it will be another year group's turn, until a better offer is made.
So for more on what we can expect today, we're joined by Chris Abercrombie from the PPTA. Morena, Chris, thank you so much for being with us this morning. What's expected today?
So today it's our expectation that no Year 11 students will be taught by PPTA members. That's up for individual schools to organise, but no Year 11s will be taught by PPTA members today.
Are the teachers actually taken to the picket lines?
No, so the teachers will remain in at school. They'll be continuing with other work. It's just no Year 11s will be taught by PPTA members today.
How significant will that disruption be to students and to parents as well?
Unfortunately, it is a disruption, and it's really unfortunate that we've come to this point. It's not something we want to do, unfortunately, but it's something that we've been forced to do.
We just had a look there with our reporter Tessa Parker on what has brought us to this point. It has been a long fight and a continued fight, right?
Absolutely, and it's really unfortunate it's come to this point. It's not what we want. We want a settled environment. We want to be in the classroom. We want to be teaching. That's why we're teachers. And it's just something that we've had to do to stand up for public education in New Zealand.
So talk us through how you think this can be resolved, Chris, because as you say, this is often a last resort for teachers, but it is something that we've seen a bit of this year already and we're expecting to see more of. So what's the hope, Chris?
Well, the hope is that we'll be able to get a settlement that both deals with recruitment and retention of teachers. Teaching is a great profession. We just need more of us.
And more money.
Absolutely. Recruitment is a big part of being able to pay your bills is a big part of recruitment. And it's about retaining the teachers we have, but it's also about encouraging people. We call them second career teachers, so people have had a career before and then come into teaching. But it's also about getting all those awesome teachers who have left teaching back into the classroom.
Yeah, how do you do that though? Because as I said, we've had this conversation a number of times on Breakfast at the moment, and I do think of those people sitting at home going, God, why would you ever want to be a teacher at the moment?
Teaching is an amazing profession. I've been doing it for 18 years. I love it. I had great teachers at school. That's why I wanted to become a teacher. And it's a fantastic profession for people to get into, but you also have to be able to pay your bills.
Yes, and so we keep having this conversation. Do you think we can actually get to a point where teachers are satisfied with the amount of money that they're being paid for to do the job that they love?
I really hope so, and I'm really confident we can. It's really hard to get a settlement when we don't have offers. It's very hard to get a settlement when we don't have anything to settle on. As I say, our last offer was October, so it's really hard to get a settlement if we don't have anything to discuss.
So what are you hoping for, or what do you need the government to come to the party with?
We need a pay rise that matches inflation. Teachers have not had a pay rise for almost 2 years now, and the cost of living has grown dramatically in those last 2 years. And so without a cost of living increase, we effectively are taking a pay cut in our buying power, and that's just unacceptable to our members.
The government would say, look, we're not a bottomless pit, and there's so many things that are taking focus at the moment, including our healthcare system, which is woefully underfunded as well. What would you say to that?
It's not an and/or. We can't have an amazing education system and a poorly funded health system, or a great health system and a poorly funded education system. We can't have that. It is not an and/or situation. It is about making sure that we have the tools we need to deal with recruitment and retention and teaching in Aotearoa New Zealand.
Because what is it like for teachers in the classroom at the moment, Chris?
It's been really difficult. We've had a really hard few years, you know, COVID disruptions, getting students back into the classroom, back into the routines. It's been really disruptive. And we've been seeing the frustration of teachers dealing with those issues, as well as having to deal with lengthy contract negotiations.
And so how concerning is it then that that there will be more disruptions now as a result of this action?
It is absolutely concerning to be more disruption, but what's more disruptive is not having subject specialist teachers. That's more disruptive to our students. So they're not going to be able to potentially reach the goals they want to reach because they don't have a suitably qualified teacher in front of them. You know, that's more disruptive. That's what we're fighting for. It's not just the students in front of us today. It's in 5 years, 10 years, 15 years' time.
This is ongoing. Do you feel like you're getting anywhere?
Absolutely. We've absolutely been seeing movement from the government every time we've engaged in industrial action. So we know it works. It moves the government. And unfortunately, that's what we have to do to move the government. We don't want to do this, but it's what the government listens to.
So today is Year 11 students. What can students and parents expect moving forward, Chris?
So there'll be information coming out from your school. So there'll be more year levels as we move forward. 2 days a week moving forward, there'll be rolling national strikes. So different regions will strike on different days. And we are hopeful we won't have to do those actions. But if we do not reach a good enough offer from the government, then we will have to continue this until we get to that point we have a settlement.
Chris Abercrombie from the PPTA, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Thank you.